Before we start this, I want to just give a clear clarification that I'm neither sponsored by any of the companies or I'm biased because I am somewhat a player of AoV since three season, 3 or 4 seasons, and it has been like 2 seasons for ML. I don't like I'm not the perfect guy to give you the full brief, but these are simply my opinions about the game and the current scenarios we have been playing in. Let's start with AoV. So AoV in India, like we will talk only about India because it's our community, like we make the community. The thing about Indian community and our game in general, like there is no lying that our server is dying and the players are getting more toxic each day. Like toxicity is something that you cannot contain or you cannot, emphasize or rectify in a day. Or it is just there. We all started as toxic because we thought we were better than other guys. Like, there is always some guy that, ruins your experience, that one particular game that triggers you. Like this was one game that triggered me a lot because of this Kricknack, you'll see. But let's quickly jump into pros of AoE. Like why is a AoE as a comparison to ML? First of all, the thing I like about AoE, it's fast paced and the small map really helps to track enemies. Like it's easy, it's basically easy. It's just an flicker of an eye and you can see that players are missing, and even the pinging mechanism won't help you much. Also, AoV has offered much better ping than ML offers because it's a crossover thing, kind of thing. And even with my cellular data off, I can play this game like very smoothly, but I cannot voice chat. That's bad on my end. Also, at number three should be rotating modes. I have enjoyed various rotating modes we have had. The clash thing, transformation thing. Arcana doesn't matter that much because when I started the Smurf, that only also account, I have like 50 or something, 48 or 50, and still I hit diamond with that easily. It doesn't matter that much. Also, this game was very easy to master, and over time it was fun. Like for most of the part, it was like failing as a team. Like sometimes we failed as a team, sometimes we got wrecked. Ibami. But otherwise, we tried all in all. Also, when you start draft picking, like after draft picking, the games get a little more intensive. But up to diamonds, it's really easy if you have a fair understanding of MOBA in general. Because MOBA are five players on your team, like on one team, that figure out a way or in a way that all players know what they have to pick and what are their strongest pick. Just sometimes you don't get to pick your main role, but you switch to secondary role. Sometimes they will compensate. Okay, like if you are MM main and you show your win rate, like a draft picking is all about showing off your win rates. Like if you have a good win rate, they will offer you your role. Like okay, you take this, and it also makes sense. Like to be fair, very fair. Also, I was never an ADC player. Like never I had dreamed of playing MM, but when I was introduced to AoE, I started playing a lot of AD carries and started to carry a lot. Basically, you do damage, you do kiting and some positional outplays. That is really fun sometimes. Sniping from ahead or blasting with Violet 2v1 outplays. Like these were the iconic moments of when I used to hardcore play it. Either ways, and also what I love about this was the objective picking of this game. Like if you rotate as a team early on, as soon as like 4 minutes, 5 minutes, there is this dragon. I have seen like all of the elos, they rotate as a team. Like not always, but they rotate. Like that is something I have really, really liked about AoE. Coming to ML, talking about ML, like it's no secret that when you start a new game, you feel this rush of playing a new game, and that excitement is, you know, unreal. If you enjoy it for the first, you know, first 10 games, that is the joy of a MOBA. Like basically you get to know like if you want to play that or play don't want to. The thing that most appealed me about ML was simply Moskva. When I saw this hero, my god, I knew that this would be my hero, like, even when I wasn't good at this game, because it's simply 10th season. I'm already trying right now. So Mobile Legends has been I don't know how, like 10 seasons on, I don't know how old this game actually is, but what I know is about the gameplay and what simple things, like simplicity. Also, let's quickly jump into the pros. First things first is the mechanic intensive gameplay. Like if you play a lot of AoE and you just try 5 games of ML, you'll understand how mechanically intensive this game is. Like actually mechanically intensive. Some fights, some 1v1 fights are really close, and if you can pull that one fight off, you know, like that one particular fight between you and that other MM or the guy you are laning with, you will feel very happy. It's not just happy, you will feel content. Maybe it's just my thing, or it could be a thing in general. That's what I feel. Also, it's a better community. Like when you start at AOV, oh my god, that general chat, like people are abusing mother sister, like whatnot. It's disturbing. It's simply disturbing. Like why would you do that? I feel bad like for the developers. Like they can't actually pin them against. And that censor thing is really bad in ML. Like if you even type something meaningful, it won't type, and it would censor NUB, like something NB. Like. But the voice chatting thing is really good on ML. Another thing I love about that is superior from AOV is the snowball mechanism. So here's the thing, okay, this is the major difference between the both of the games. Snowballing mechanism, if you get ahead 2 kills, okay, like this is where you are supposed to be, or where you are ahead of your laner, either you over farm them so that you can get that life steal and that damage that eventually you can fight them in tough scenarios. So you are ahead and you are like rolling over your opponents, and you are getting this what do you say, like superiority, you know. At this point you just know you are getting ahead, you are pushing towers and everything. Like there is a slight chance they come back if you do major mistakes, like not minor but major. That is something I really like about ML. You have to be very precise with your gameplay, and you have to be very calculative as well, because few things can make or break the game, even one team fight. It's that. But also if your other team has like 10 or 15 kills ahead, there is almost no chance of coming back, and that is something I like, because the other team has actually played much better. That simply suggests that. Also, this game is hard to climb, man, like actually hard to climb. Not that I'm new, but if you play your roles, even your roles correctly, sorry, you'll get to know that masters in some games in masters, okay, that equals flat games of AoE. That is like 4 divisions ahead of you, like 3-4 divisions ahead of what it should be. I have played games, oh my god, I have carried so many games and like lost as well. Like I'm not that good, but you'll know if you play a lot. But it makes it more fun, you know, if you lose, if you win, if you lose, if you win. There is this rush. like, okay, we are getting good opponents, we have to do better next time. Like, that is what motivates me to keep going on and on and on and spam to get those desired win rates. It was easy to get Chhattisgarh rank 1 Moscow, by the way. Like, I don't know if even players from my city play this game, but I like Moscow. Also, what I have realized, a major thing about this thing, ML, is that GM, that is Grandmaster, that is greater than AoE Diamond Elo. Like, hear me on this, okay? Like, Diamond Elo is draft picking, I agree. But the people are so bad at AoE, oh my god, they'll simply... Even if you pick a support hero, no, like Thane or something, you will cry. So, like, you will scratch your eyes. Like, why did I pick support hero? You will be in regret. Whereas in ML, if you pick support heroes, no, there are such fun support heroes. Oh my god, there's Angela, there's Estus. If you play such heroes, you will know, okay, I can even play this hero. Like, there are support heroes who change the games, like pace of the games. It is that good. Farming and carrying, like, some games are good, some games are bad, but there are games that you over farm and carry everything. Like, people have been saying that ML is a solo carry game, but they don't realize the the hardship behind it. It is not easy to farm like all game. If the other team is snowballing and you have to carry all those games, like, simply over farming and capitalizing every moment, it is not easy. As a player, I have seen, I have turned games myself, I have funneled gold to my carries. Like, that is how a MOBA should be. Also, there are quick updates like patch notes, and there is almost no delay between that. And the rewarding system, oh my god, this is like one of the major vital things of ML. Like, they reward you nicely. Like, it is quite easy to get that one hero and spam that guy. So people generally get heroes, and you get like 5-6 heroes. That is very nice, and also of one of your choice. That is something AoE should learn, not just a money grabbing company. Because Moonton is more, or like, I don't know if there is an equal comparison, because that is how a company survives, that I understand. But still, you should, reward your players who have been there for a long time and they have invested time and energy in your game. It's something these companies need to realize, not just as a business perspective, but as a player. You need to understand the needs of your consumers. Basically, these were the pros. Let's talk about the cons right now. The queue timers. Like, the queue timers in AoE, oh my god. If you reach diamond, it is almost impossible to climb the ladder in Trioque. But Trioque has been known to, like, easy climb, and you can trust at least two guys in your team rather than going solo and not even getting your role. Solo is like, solo queue is solo cry. If I were to describe it in a sentence, it is like that. Also, the community is quite small, and that small community is very toxic. It has like 12-year-old kids who will abuse you, who would rather abuse you than play the game. That is bad. Like, that is bad. I don't know like how to describe it. That is bad as a nation, as a, people are from other servers are so disappointed with our language, the how we treat others, the Vietnamese. Like, I think they're the best who know how do we get and we treat others. That's something we have to look forward to. I was tilted this game, please excuse me. Also, we have unskilled players, as you saw that Kriknak just ran away while that yawn was charging at me. Like, that is something that triggers me a lot. As an MM main, you need to understand, like, it was a 2v1 situation, but this yawn did not, this Kriknak did not help me. Like, it could go both ways. Either he was very low and I was at a position that That is what no similar level of understanding while being at the same elo. Also, let's talk about major things like a Valor Cup. It is something that is treated as a joke. Like Valor Cup, you are only getting 50 hero tokens. Like what are we supposed to do with that? Like seriously, like 50 tokens is like for those skins, fancy skins, I guess. But Valor Cup was once very famous. There was this summer tournament, like every team of the nation, of the country participated. I think that was the peak time where we all got to witness the great teams. And surprisingly, like I had a squad and our team was supposed to be placed at 6th all over India, like 6th, actually 6th, and that was huge, I think, at the moment. But we ended up at 8 because the timer stopped after 12 a.m. like the deadline. After that deadline we spammed last day and we got to 6 from 32. Like that was something I am really happy about, and we got to compete at a very high level. But XD Monopoly was still there. Like they owned that game. They were the undisputed champions of that game in our server. We were so scared to face them. Even like teams were like, what this, five guys were absolutely unbeatable. Like there was, never mind, not going to fanboy or something, but I just admire that classic five man. Also, I think the promotions, like one of the downgrades of our server is the simply the promotions. Like there aren't much or better promotions I have been seeing. The last I saw was around summer tournament, that is, and that's something I disliked about. Now let's switch to ML. Well, ML is a game where we have crossover ping issues when an Indonesian or other guys try to play this game, and we have this sudden ping spikes. That is something I don't like, or nobody would like. If you are delaying for a second or 1.5 second, it triggers you. It actually triggers you. Also, there is no, like, not much objective play even at a higher level. I have been playing at Epic. Like, I'm not that good, but I'm at Epic. I'm not climbing at the moon because I don't have those emblems, which is a major issue because I main MM and jungle, and I don't get to jungle if I. Like there are players who will sometimes take ADC role from you and you can do nothing about that. So I want to have like secondary picks. That has been a thing that I'm struggling with, and I recently got Karina and she's also nice. So that was my take on ML versus AoE. If you did find something interesting or you have something to add to, please do give feedback. It helps. And also, happy new year, guys.